हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड आईटी गेट कोचिंग। डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन टू गेट द इंस्टेंट नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ माय फ्री लेक्चर।
सो दिस इज अबाउट मी। आई एम योर कंप्यूटर साइंस गेट फैकल्टी, हैविंग मोर देन 5 प्लस ऑफ टीचिंग एक्सपीरियंस, मेंटर्ड मोर देन 50,000 स्टूडेंट्स, टॉट इन डिफरेंट कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट ऑल ओवर इंडिया। ओके, इट्स लाइक द गेट एकेडमी, इवन क्वालिफाइड मल्टीपल टाइम्स गेट। And even I have given the coaching in many government colleges as well as in many private colleges. Like in SRM Chennai, I have given coaching. CET Bhubaneswar, I have given. BC Bhagalpur, Jorhat College of Engineering, Guwahati University, Dibrugarh University, Government College of Engineering and Technology, Jammu, Ramgarh Engineering College. Okay, these are the colleges where I have went and I have given the coaching. Now we will come to Radix Sort. Now in Radix Sort, what we do? Here the restriction is we first know the base of the number system. Here we first know the base of the number system. Okay. Here in Radix Sort. Now see the Radix Sort. Now in Radix Sort also we are having one restriction, that base of the number system should be known. In Radix Sort, base of the number system should be known. So in Radix Sort, first we have to decide about the base of the number system, the number system. So we have to first decide the base, means whether you are going to use decimal number system or binary number system or ternary number system, that you have to first say here. Okay, so here let's assume here that we are going to use decimal number system. Okay, so let's assume here that we are going to use decimal number system. Now see, first I will explain you the way we are going to do, then I will give you the algorithm. Okay, first I will explain. So let's assume you are having some number given input. Let's assume, since the decimal number system, so you are having some number like 804, 26, 5, 64, 52, 1. You are having some numbers like this. Okay, so first you have to find the bigger number out of that. Okay, so you write the number, like you write 804, then 26, then 5, then 64, then 52, then 1. So you have find the bigger number. Here is 804. It is having a 3 digit, 1 2 3 3 digit. Okay, so ones place, tens place and 100 place you are having the number. So you have to make all the remaining number containing 3 digit. So if it is not having 3 digit net, then append zero in the beginning, add zero in the beginning. This is the thing first you have to do. Okay, now you will do, you know here that in any place, just like in ones place, it will have some number from 0 to 9. See, if you will see, if it is a decimal number, then it will have some number, some digit, like here it will have either 0 to 9, because it's a decimal number system. So in any place you know that it will have some number system from 0 to 9. Now you do the sorting in ones place. First you do the sorting in ones place. Now see, you know that the range here, you know that 0 to 9. So your range, you know that from 0 to 9. So you can use here counting sort to sort the ones place. See, if you are facing difficulties, you can let me know. So I'm saying that you are going to sort the number based on the digit which is present in ones place, okay. And since you know the range of the number, range is going to be 0 to 9, any number will be have 0 to, you can use the counting sort, and now it is going to sort the number based on the digit that is placed on ones place. So how it is going to sort? Now see, one is the smaller, and you are going to use the stable sorting. Why stable sorting? Because if some number is repeated, like if you are having 01 here and 01 here, so that should come first. Stable sort, it is going to maintain the relative index. Okay, stable sorting you are going to use. and counting sort is a stable sort. Okay, and counting sort is a stable sort. Okay, so you can write here, you can write here in the counting sort, it is a counting sort is a counting sort is a stable sort. Counting sort is a stable sort. It's a stable sort. Okay, so it is going to maintain the relative position. It's going to maintain the relative position. Counting sort is a stable sort. Okay, it is going to maintain the relative position. Fine. Now when you do the sorting based on ones place, so one will come first, so you will write 001 first, then 052 will come because this is one, then two, this two done, then four will come. Now see, here it is having four, here it is having four. Now which four will come first? These four will come first because this four is coming early. Okay, this four is coming early because relative position of these four is before this, then 064. So these two done, then this will get sorted, then this 026. Now when you have did the sorting by using the ones place, now ones digit number will get in its correct relative position. Ones digit number, see, ones digit number is 1 and here 5, see, ones come before 5, see, ones digit number gets sorted, ones digit number gets sorted, see, 1 and 5 is getting sorted, it is in correct relative position. Now we will do the sorting by, here we have first sort by first place, then we will do by using second place, by using second place. Again we can call the counting sort on this. So 0 is here, here 0 is here, here. So this will come first because its relative position is first. Then this will come 804, then 005. Because 0 will come first. Since its relative position is before than this, that's why this came before, then this. Now 2, 026, then 052. 052, then 064. See, so this sorted, this gets sorted first. Okay, then 2, it's 6. Then you got this one, then this one. See, now when you sort by using second place, so all the number which is having two digit, all the numbers which is having two digit get its correct position. See, this number, it's a two digit number. 26 is smaller than 52, it's in correct position. 52 is smaller than 64, see, it is coming early. It is coming early. Okay, now at last you are going to have to, you are going to do third place. Third place you are going to do. So this 001 will come first. This is done. Then 005 will come first. Then 026 will come first. Then 052 will come first. Then 064. And then 804, see. When you have sort the by using third place, all the element which is having three digit is got sorted. Three digit is got sorted. See, this comes first, then this. Now see, this got sorted. Now this got sorted. Okay. So in this way we are going to do. So that's why it's called its radix sort, because it every radix, first ones place, then twos place, then third place. Okay, means ones, tens, hundred, thousand, like this we are going to do the sorting. Am I clear? So now I will give the algo. Now we will give the algorithm for that. Okay. Now algorithm. So first I have explained you how this is working. Now write the algorithm for that. Okay. So radix sort. So this the same way I have taken from the Corman book. Okay. This is the array. This is the array and the digit means an array which is having the largest digit. Okay. This is a digit. Okay. So you can write each digit, each key, each value in array 1 to 9, in array 1 to 9, 1 to n is a d digit number, is a d digit number. Okay, so it's having means 3 digit 4 digit 5 digit. So it's d is saying that it's a d digit number, because you should know it's a d digit integer or number, you can write. And if the key are not of d digit, if the value is not d digit, then we have to make d digit number, then we have to make d digit number by appending 0 zero by appending zero. So you have to append zero to make. Okay. Fine. So this is a multiple line comment. So you should use multiple line comment. This is a single line comment. So use multiple line comment. This is the multiple line comment. Okay. Now you are going to run for I equal to 1 to D. Okay. I equal to 1 to do D 2. So what you are going to do? This is I equal to 1 is saying that at 1's place. Then I equal to 2, 10's place. Then I equal to 3, 3rd means 100 place. So like this, it is going to be first digit I equal to. Now you are going to do call stable sorting, like counting sort you can call here. So use a stable. You require a stable sorting algorithm. You require a stable sorting algorithm to sort A on digit I. Okay. So use a stable sorting algorithm to sort array A on digit I. Okay. So you can write here digits are numbers 1 to D from right to left it has number from right to left you have number the digits from 1 to D. Okay, so right one is having 1, then 2 like this. This is having number 1, this is 2, then this is 3. You are having D equal to 3, so it will run from 1 to D, 1 2 3 like this, 1 2 then 3 till D, and at every place you are going to call the stable sorting on array on digit i. Okay, so if you are done with the writing, then you can let me know, and if any place if you are having doubt, feel free to ask me. Now we are going to analyze the time complexity and the space complexity. So today our sorting algorithm is going to finish. Okay, today our sorting algorithm is going to finish. So this is the last sorting algorithm that we are having in our syllabus. So we have seen every sorting. I have not left any. Sorting is very important, even if you will consider as you are in semester exam. Okay, and even in your placement. Now try to find the time complexity. Now think, what is going to be the time complexity? You are running this loop from 1 to D. 1 to do it is going to, so this for loop is going to run till D times. Okay, and D is the number of digit, and every times you are going to call some stable sort that we are going to call here counting sort. And counting sort time complexity is your n plus k. N is your number of element, and k is the size of the array. What is going to be the size of the array? Since here base of the number system is b, size of the array, it will be 10 from 0 to 9 0, so it will have 10 elements. So size of the array is going to 10. Okay, whatever will be the base, that is going to be the size of the array, 0 to 9. So you are going to add plus 1 for 0, 10 element it is having. So since here base of the number system is B, so size of the array in counting sort is going to be B. Okay, big O of B. So here time complexity is going to run this for loop till d times, and every times you are going to call the counting sort, and counting sort time complexity is n plus k. So your total time complexity is going to your d n plus k. Sorry, b here k here in place of k, you should write b, because array size here is b. Okay, n plus b. Is it fine? Now we will see. So this is the time complexity. Okay, so average case you are going to get this. This is going to your average case. average case. Now we will try to find the worst case and the base case. Worst case and the base case. Now let me take some number. If I take some decimal number, if I take some number like 10, then how many digits you are required to represent 10? 2. You require 2 digits. 1, 2. What is that? 10 to the power 10? 10. Okay. So if you will take, what if base is 10? Like if you will take some number, if you will take some number, let L be the largest digit. I am assuming let L be the largest digit number. I am assuming that let L be the largest digit number. I am trying to find the number of digit D. Okay. So let L be the largest digit number in this number system. So the number of digit that is required to represent L is going to be log L base B. Log L base B. Okay. So this is the way you can require number of digit you require. Okay. Number of digit. By default it is 2, but here we will use base B because our base is going to your B. Okay. So let L be the digit. Let L be the largest digit. So the number of digit required to represent L. So to require to represent L will be log L base B. Okay. So if your largest digit number is L, then you are going to the number of digit to require to represent L is going to log L base B. So your time complexity is going to your, so your time complexity in place of D, you can write D is the number of digit only you are having. So it's going to log L base B. It's going to be N plus B. Okay. Now let's assume when the largest number is very big, let L equal to some 2 to the power k. Okay, 2 to the power k. I am assuming n to the power k. Okay. It's going to be a very big number. I am assuming it's a largest number is your very big number. n to the power k. Okay. Means n is your total number. And that is going to be bigger. Okay. Bigger number it is having. Okay. Largest number is very big. N to the power k. Then in place of L, you will substitute that. In place of that L, you will substitute n to the power k. And here you are having base B. And you are having here n plus B. So k will come, then log n base b plus n plus b. So you can say that in worst case it is going to be n into log n base b. See, in worst case it is going to take the time complexity as the compression based algorithm. See, n log n base b. Is it clear? Please let me know. So your worst case time complexity is going to be n log n. Please comment whether it is clear or not. Because you can assume the largest number as very big number. It's going to be n to the power k. So in place of L, you are substituting n to the power k. K comes in front, then log n base b. It's going to n log n base b. Okay. Fine. So this you have seen the worst case. Now in best case, what can happen? Okay. Now tell me what is going to be the best case. So when number of element is equal to is equal to, or you can say become close, or you can say close, okay, when number of element become close to the, when number of element become close to base of the number system, base of the number system. Okay, so from one it is having time complexity as it is having k log n base b, then it is having n plus b. Okay, so b is going to be your n when it is going to be very close. So it is going to be your 1. So k n plus b, that is going to your big of n. So your best case is going to your omega n. So when number system and total number of element, when total number of element you are going to have is close to the base of the number system, when number of element become close to the number system, become close to base of the number system, then it is going to your B of omega n. Okay. Now what is going to be the space complexity? Now you people tell me, what is going to be the space complexity here? So your space complexity is going to your this algorithm is not required anything. Okay, just for I equal to 1 to 2, you are using some stable sorting, that counting sort. For counting sort, whatever will be the space complexity, that is going to be the space complexity. Okay, so here space complexity is only for, counting sort. Okay, and what is going to be the space complexity of counting sort? And that, for that we only, and for that we only need a array of size whatever will be the base b. So a space complexity is, big of b. So here space complexity is only for counting sort. Space complexity is going to only for counting sort, and for that we only need an array of size b, because b is the base of the number system. So space complexity is big of b. So your sorting is completed.